And this time I'll be describing a different murmur. I'll write down the name in a few minutes from now. But first listen to the inputs here. The first diagram here shows ventricular systole, where the ventricles are generating force and this is causing opening of aortic and the pulmonic valves. So 80 ml blood is racing into the aorta and 80 ml blood is racing into the pulmonary artery of the patient. But then after a few milliseconds later, when the ventricles have done their responsibility, the ventricles will relax and aortic and pulmonic valve will close. That's where the problem starts. I am here signifying or showing that aortic valve is closing but is not closing properly, unlike pulmonic valve which is closing rock solid. You see, the pulmonic valve is closing efficiently so that there is no leakage of blood back into the heart of the patient. But in my patient, there is a defective closure of aortic valve which is causing blood to leak back into the ventricular cavity of the patient. So in patients who are suffering from severe aortic regurgitation, the words are severe, where as much as 50% of the blood could be leaking back into the heart of the patient. Out of 80 ml, 40 ml is coming back. So in severe aortic regurgitation, there is a substantially large volume of blood that is going to come into the heart of the patient. And some of this blood you can see, like, you know, it's going to hit the mitral valve leaflets also. This is where the mitral valve leaflets are. Tricuspid valve, mitral valve. So the blood is going to race back into the heart of the patient with so much of aggression that even it's going to hit mitral valve leaflets. Though there is no disease of the mitral valve, but even mitral valve here is getting accidentally involved in a sense that the blood is racing back into the heart and it's creating turbulence. It is called creating noise. This noise is due to defective A2, that is defective aortic valve closure. So this is how it is when you will auscultate this patient. You will notice the fact that in this patient, the murmur will not begin from opening snap, because opening snap is the time when mitral and tricuspid valve will open. So the murmur will not begin from opening snap. The problem is not in the mitral valve. It will begin from S2. It will peak in the middle of the diastole and then gradually the pressure will come down. So this would once again be called as a mid-diastolic murmur. It's called as mid-diastolic because the max intensity is in the middle of the diastole. Do remember the fact that mitral stenosis murmur starts from the opening snap, peaks around this time, and then it has a small secondary spike. So this mitral stenosis murmur that was discussed earlier has a configuration different from that I've described at the moment to you. At the moment, what I've described to you is that if a patient is having severe variety of aortic regurgitation, the volume of blood leaking back into the heart of the patient is substantial, and this can cause a development of a mid-diastolic murmur in the patient. This is technically known as Austin-Flint murmur. Austin-Flint murmur is a classical term to describe mid-diastolic murmur or severe aortic regurgitation, and the starting point of this particular murmur is from S2, that is second heart sound, and not from the opening snap, which is shown in color red, belongs to mitral stenosis. Now, just to see whether you and me are on the same frequency, look at the diagram again and compare with the previous one. In this sketch, I will be showing mild aortic regurgitation. So this is the representation of diastole. Just be patient, give me a few seconds. Pulmonic valve is closing rock solid, but aortic valve is not closing properly. So there is leakage of blood back into the heart of the patient, but the amount of blood leaking is very less. Very limited amount of blood. So in this sketch, you can see the fact that I have tried to show mild variety of aortic regurgitation where little bit of blood is leaking back in the heart, let me say 5 ml and not a substantially large volume. Even this patient will be having a defective A2, but you would agree to the fact that in this patient, because less amount of blood is coming back, therefore the noise in the heart will be lesser. Previously, more blood was coming in, so the noise will be relatively more. Here, less blood is coming in, so the noise would be lesser. And secondly, the murmur will also last for a shorter duration. Less blood, shorter duration, and more blood, longer duration. So, mild aortic regurgitation, the murmur can be represented in the following fashion. You will definitely hear turbulence in the phase of diastole. But this turbulence, which I'm now showing before you, will begin from the A2 part. A2 is defective. So the turbulence will begin from here and would die down very soon. this kind of a triangular configuration that I have given before you is known as early diastolic murmur. So in mild aortic regurgitation, because there is little bit of blood going in the heart, the duration of murmur will also be shorter. We are gonna call it a early diastolic murmur. And in case you just missed it out, I can just do this again on the contralateral side. Follow the words. If a patient is having a mild pulmonic regurgitation, there's a defective P2, for example, then in defective P2, little bit of blood will leak back in the heart of the patient and will produce noise. So I'm going to show another murmur here in a different fashion, but with a different color, to highlight the fact that if there is a defective P2 in the patient, then the murmur will definitely occur in a patient that would also be called as an early diastolic murmur. But aortic and pulmonic valves don't close together. Remember, yesterday we discussed splitting of second heart sound is best heard at the ERS point. This time lag is about 30 milliseconds. So in case both aortic and pulmonic regurgitation of the mild variety are present in a patient, then mild aortic regurgitation murmur will occur first and then pulmonic regurgitation murmur, because there is a time lag of 30 milliseconds between the two. So this would be called as early diastolic murmur. Time lag of 30 milliseconds is present between the two closure of the aortic and the pulmonic valves. In contrast, the previous murmurs were mid-diastolic.